We are going to build an Alpakka open source controller like this one in black and silver, though it could be in any other colors or materials or with any mods we want because it's 3D printed and it's open source. We will do it in three parts, getting a PCB and soldering some of the components on it, then 3D printing the case and the buttons, and assembling it all together. Starting with the PCB, we get the production files from Input Labs website. Then we use a PCB prototyping service to manufacture the PCBs and send them to us. Most of the components are already soldered on the front of the PCB, but we still have to solder some more of them, such as the trigger buttons, the pico, the thumbstick, the scroll wheel encoder, directional switch, and front-facing buttons. We can 3D print this soldering stand to make the process much easier. It holds the PCB flat and all the components in place while we solder them. We solder the trigger buttons on the back of the PCB with the help of any piece of tape or a sticker. Then the tape is not needed anymore to solder the other legs. And we do the same with all the four buttons. Now for the pico, we place it center on the back of the PCB, and we do the same trick with a piece of tape. Solder one of the corners, and all the other connections. We place the thumbstick in the stand. And solder all the pins. For the directional switch, it's easier if we place it on the PCB first and then flip it with the stand. And we solder the pins. The scroll wheel encoder snaps in place. And we solder the pins and the lateral legs. And the last thing we have to solder are the forward-facing buttons, and they snap in as well. And that's it, the PCB is complete. Now for the 3D printing part, we get the 3D models from Input Labs website. And we print the front case, the back case, and the buttons, triggers, and all the other stuff, which again could be printed in any color combination or with any modifications we want or need. The only part that is a bit special is the hexagon, which is designed to be touch sensitive, so it must be printed with a conductive material. And we have everything, so we can finally put it together. We start with the triggers. These are secured with a bolt and a nut. They have to be a bit loose to operate properly. The other triggers use the same mechanism, so another bolt and a nut. The PCB stays in place using the mounting holes, but we have to apply force carefully. We fit the thumbstick cap. For the scroll wheel, we insert the shaft into the wheel. Then we put the wheel into the encoder, and this support part rests on the top of the PCB. We fit the directional hat. For the anchors, we put the nut into the slot and hold it using a bolt from the other side. Then we insert them into the case. The point of this is so the nut is now embedded into the case. The touch-sensitive hexagon has a cross-pattern shape that fits by pressing it down until there is no gap. We place all the buttons into their slots, and I'm not sure why is this so satisfying. Your guess is as good as mine. Now holding both front and back cases, we carefully put them in vertical so nothing falls over from either side. Then put the anchors into their guides and close it. We place the last pair of nuts into their slots. And the bolts keep the cases together. Then the last pair of bolts. And finally, the back cover that goes by pressure. And that's it.